Swing up time. Take a breath. Arms up. Externally, repeat again. Breathe in. Arms up. And release one more time. Come on. Take a deep breath. Perfect. Chin march. That's a little better. Right, very simple. We're going to walk forward, clap and go back. Are you ready? Walk forward. Clap and go back. And again, ladies. Good morning again. Show me again. Oh, we need to waken up out there. Come on, girls, focus your mind and your body in here. Walk to the right corner now. Up and go back. Same corner, same corner. Come back, beautiful. Center, ladies, right now. Get back. And again, and again. Ready for left corner. Left side, walk, walk, walk. And again, ladies. No problem. Center, two more times. Front, keep going. Watch me. Right knee. Left knee. Right knee forward. Left knee back. Take it back. Right knee forward. Left knee back. There we go. That's it. Just like a silent night on the dance floor. Now, keep it in your spot. Right here. Keep it. Good. We're going to get the heart rate up, girls. We're going to move our bodies. That's it. Easy peasy. Here we go. Front to carry on. Yeah? Keep going, watch. Right side, left side. Join me. Right side, left side. Do the legs first. Then worry about the arms later. Doesn't matter if you make a mistake, just keep on moving. Good. Take the arm up in the air. Reach for the ceiling. That's it, come on. Strong body movement. Now take it behind you, double up. Take it behind, double up. Another way to go. That's it, Ricky, Ricky, go. Oh, she's so tired. Side to side again, girls. Good. Come on. Excellent. Take it behind again, right now. Okay, okay. Perfect. Now you're welcome to stay with this. If you want to make it a more tense, try this. Arms full to it. But you're welcome to stay with the low impact version. Your choice, as long as you get warm and happy. There we go. Another way to go. No smiling, please. You're not supposed to enjoy yourself. Remember, side to side, side to side, right side, left side. If you want to make it a little more tense, jazz, your choice. You bend your knees. There we go. Ooh, the arm is smiling. Another way to go, people. Ready for a simple march again? Back to a march. Take a deep, deep breath. Excellently, 10 feet behind the bar, ladies. Heels down, double time squats. Good. So hopefully the game there should start to feel a bit of a difference. Do you mind your breathing? That's key to a good workout. Keep going, watch me. Shift my weight from side to side. Join me, ladies, to their left knees. Clench your fists. Place it in guard position. Think of a target, punch that target directly ahead of you. That's it, come on now. I know you want to punch someone. I can sense it. So punch someone. There you go. Why are you looking at me when you're doing that? Anybody else? Easy. You mean arm swing side to side. Good. Lose your arms all together. Back to squats double time. Are we a little warmer now?
Yeah.
All right, then. Let's keep moving now. We're not quite there yet. Slow it down. Slow and lift. Make sure the feet remain flat. Abs in a little bit now. Good. Simple and easy. Anything I do remember is optional. So if I go to a position you're comfortable with, simply don't do it. Let's start easy. Right arm down, right arm up. I'm going to stop squatting. I'm going to go across the body. Perfect. Swap over left arm. Out and across. Now in a second when you alternate, we're going to slow it down. Right over left, slow. Take a breath and swap over. And again, focus on controlling it. If it doesn't feel comfortable back, then don't go too far, remember. Good. Last two times. Next time we're going to hold, ladies. Hold on the right side. more weight. Make it easy. We're going to do some listen up and some stretching. But again, remember, go as far as you like. I'm going to take my right hand down towards my right foot. Your choice. I'm now going to straighten out both legs. Tummy must be in. Hips go in that direction. Head in that direction. Bottom arm down, top arm up. Beautiful. Now again, the next one's a little tricky. We're going to drop the left arm down. And we're going to reverse the position carefully. Don't change position with your feet, please. This is all about ability work for your back. Some of you may find this easy, some of you may not. Beautiful. A few more seconds, ladies. Take your right arm to the floor, stay low, bring your head and body to the center. Head and body to the center. Now, just check that both toes are facing directly forward. Whatever happens, do not allow your heels to come to the floor. In other words, ladies, keep your feet flat. Now, walk your hands as far forward as they'll go. But again, without lifting up your heels. Then, push the head and chest out. For those who are familiar with the term, downward dog position. Now, think of a little triangle, a little pyramid. How about some breathing still? Yes. Now, if you really tilt your pelvis up, you should do a good stretch either across the back of your legs, or across your hips, or across your back, or maybe a little bit all three. Good. Do try to really lift your bum up. Remember, if your bum touches the ceiling, have a word with me, and we'll do something for that. Good. Now, walk your hands carefully back in. Bend your knees. Place your hands in your thighs. Come up slowly, not too fast. As soon as you're ready to do so, right arm up towards the left side. And breathe. Good. Optional, slide the left hand down towards the left ankle or foot. Optional, straighten out both legs carefully. Good. Think about your position for a moment. Yeah. So hips that way, head that way, top arm up, bottom arm down. Good. A few more seconds and I want you to drop your top arm, reverse it. Drop your top arm down and lift your left arm up and look as much as you can towards the back. Do it slowly, do it controlled. But be a little bit firm as well. Right. A good stretch is like a good exercise. You need to push yourself a little into the position. Don't fall over them. Unless you've been drinking. You've been drinking, haven't you? Take your arm down. Beautiful. Now keep low. Bring your body to center. Once more, make sure both feet are facing forward. Take a breath. As you breathe out, walk your hands between the legs, towards the back wall. Straighten out your legs and as high as you can lift up your pelvis. But let your upper body relax. Again, you may feel this in the back of your legs, you may feel this in your hips, or back, or maybe a combination. Very good. Bring your hands to center, bend both knees, place your hands on top of your thighs, and slowly roll up. As soon as you're up there, shake out your arms and legs. If you want to have a quick sip of water, go ahead. We're going to go straight to some upper body work. Grab your hand weights, let's go. If you haven't got your hand weights, there's hand weights behind the wall over there, so go and grab some. Now remember the purpose of any strength work, especially when you're looking at resistance like weights. Don't make it easy. Alright, it will start easy hopefully, but once we get going, do expect some hard work. Anyway, let's talk number one. Stand nice and tall, please. Pick up your hand weights. Not pick up your hand weights. We'll start a very simple one to give it. And double bicep curl like this. All the way up and all the way down. So our main focus is the muscles that lie across the front of the arm. However, with most upper body work, we also have to consider our posture. We don't want to do about this, do we? Slouching. So, try to keep focused on keeping your chest lifted. Keep your tummy a little bit in. Keep your chin parallel to the floor. And no smiling. Very dangerous. Good. Excellent. And look in that mirror. Yeah. Try to focus on what you're trying to do with these exercises. Think about, for instance, 3 months, 4 months down the line. Try to focus on your results. And make it worth your while. Don't waste your time in here. Come on, keep going. Stay up. And steady down. Now alternate, right to left. Easy up right, take it down, easy up left. Perfect, keep going. Now when you're alternating, have a little lock into your posture again, especially when you look at the level of your shoulders. What you don't want to do is start lifting one shoulder up to compensate. Keep your shoulders level, just work from the lower part of the arms. There you go. Ooh, I like this series looks. You folks be practicing again, I see them. Good. Let's go for double arm right now. All the way up, all the way down. Good. Careful not to start swinging. I can do this all day long because I'm swinging the weight. I need to think about controlling it. Keep my elbows tucked next to the rib cage and thick biceps. Good. That's it. You do have to have a certain amount of determination, ladies. Very good. Back to alternate. But as soon as one goes down, the other one comes up. So it's my right arm goes down, my left arm comes up. Perfect. Work those weights. Don't be afraid of them. The How do you get that this? Because it gives you results. Yeah, I'm sure Judy will agree. That can be hard. That's it. You've got to get out of your comfort zone, ladies, and get into your workout zone. 25 minutes, make it worth your while. Very good. We're nearly done. Now give you double arm and double tongue speed. Up and down. Power and down. And again, don't sway the body. Keep the body perfectly still. Which means knees slightly bent, abs tucked in, elbows locked down next to rib cage. Good. Hammer those muscles. Come on, there you go. Good. Now we're getting to the stage where we eat the Brussels sprouts. We don't like this anymore. But it's working. Couple more to go. One more time. Fantastic. Pull the weights down, roll your shoulders. Everyone okay? Of course you are. Now let's go to the tricep. I want everyone to face the center of the room. So you ladies face it this way. You ladies face it this way. And then you can choose. Now, position is simple. I'll turn sideways so you can see. Give me about half the squat, please. Half the squat. So you bend your knees, push your tailbone out. So if you look in the mirror, you should have a ski slope back and tailbone to neck. Now, raise your elbows to be roughly slightly higher than the rear cage behind. All you need to do is push directly behind, straighten your arms if you can, and then bring it back forward. Squeeze behind and release. So now the force is coming into the opposing muscle group to the biceps. Which would be? Triceps, right? Or back of the arm, bingo wings, chicken wings, whatever you want to call them. But did you order some chicken wings for the summer? No, we didn't. We're going to have firm arms. We're not going to be able to beat the stuff on a windy day and have our arms flapping about. No. We're going to get firm arms. So again, look in that mirror. Visualize where you want to get to. Squeeze into those weights. Take a break if you really need to. I don't mind. It's not a competition, but I want you to do well. Not many more to go. That's it. Last 200. 199. Watch that back, please. Keep it nice and straight. Don't shrug your shoulders. One more time. Perfect. Stand upright. Roll your shoulders. Turn to the front. Now, you can use one or two weights. Your choice. I'm going to use two. You can do the same, but choose one. Hold the weights. We've got the square weights. Hold them to the either end. Take it above your heads. Cross the behind the head and neck while bending the elbows. And then straight back up. Perfect. So these are called tricep pushes. Nice and simple. And again, you can see where you're working. Look in that mirror. Try to focus on where you're trying to head to. Good. Try and keep the elbows parallel to the head, so don't allow them to go too far out. That's it. What about breathing? Some of you are looking a little bit blue from behind you. Please breathe. Good. And feel it working. Make it hard work. Make it two weights if you can handle it. Squeeze it up. You've got to do it. There's no question about it. You've got to do it. You'll find me one day, you know, 20 years from now, you'll be sitting down somewhere being, oh, how can I just keep it out? Oh, I still remember his workouts. I'm so glad he did that to me. Come on! Get it done! Last couple to go. Tell me, is it working for you?
Yeah.
It should be. It should be agony right now. Excellent. Take the weights in front. Roll your shoulders. Last word. Separate the weights. Stand tall, feet a little wide. Pass as you can. Don't mark. Curl back to biceps. Oh, no nonsense. Steady up, steady down. Good. Now again, when you get tired, that's when the mistakes start to occur. What's the most common mistake with bicep? The shoulders. Slouching. Try to think about pushing out your chest. By doing so, your shoulders will push back. They have to. Which means you'll get a much better bicep workout. Plus, your boobs will look bigger. And I think that's a plus. Keep going. Seriously. Work on those arms. That's it. That's it. It's all about state of mind. Proper workouts will never be comfortable, they'll never be likable. Just carry on. That's it, good. Just picture yourself on your holiday. Yeah? On your favorite beach, in your favorite bikini. Just be feeling good, looking good, because you work hard at it. Now ladies, alternate, right to left. First your right arm, take it down, then the left arm. Squeeze into the front of the arm. Don't let those shoulders take over muscular work. Watch your back, no twisting or arching or reaching. Good. Double arm a little faster. Double arm. Double arm. Squeeze it. That's it. Power, ladies. Remember, you are strong. Keep going. There we go. We're only in now. Excellent. Back to alternate. As soon as one goes down, the other one comes up. Keep a steady pace. Bend your there, remember. Muscles need energy in order to function. And energy comes from breaking down energy. Without oxygen, that energy supply becomes really low and really hard to get to. so breathe, stay in control. Don't hyperventilate because that doesn't work either. You're just getting dizzy. Keep it going, pulsing, double time, come on. Ooh, is it burning yet? Is it pinching? Double arm last time now. Double arm, come on. Squeeze, you need to double your biceps. We're not gonna do any more arm biceps after this. Just four more to go, girls. That's it, come on, find your own body. Give me one more. Excellent, give your arms a short rest, keep holding the weight. Back to triceps, turn sideways, please, into the center of the room. All right, let's have the forward angle leaps. Stomach in, slightly bend your knees. Raise your elbows next to your rib cage. Look in the mirror if you need to. Full extension back. Full extension back hip. Perfect. Now, when you look at triceps, which is probably a slightly more important muscle, and probably slightly more concerning for most ladies toward the back of the arms and in front of the arms, how many muscles do you think are on triceps? Work for you. Three separate muscle groups. Now, in order to shape the arm as good as you can, you need to reactivate all three to the full potential. Now, doing this kind of movement is okay, but it doesn't quite work all three. It works mainly two, but the third one gets a little bit later in this angle. So what I want to do, as I push the weight away, I turn my thumbs outwards, then back to normal. So if I can stick my thumb out, I can feel the difference in contraction. It's much harder to do. Give it a try if you wish. Yeah. Not inwards, outwards, like you're sticking out your thumb for a lift. But keep those elbows next to your ribcage, pointing behind you. Feel the difference. And look at the difference. You can see the muscle contraction much better, girls. Show me that shape. Good. Eight more to go. Careful not to swing the weight, girls. I want you to squeeze it. No need to shrug. Remember, oh, what about tummies? Is it touch the floor? It better not be. One more time. Oh, that's nasty. Excellent. Stand up. Roll your shoulders. Put one or two weights together. Or choose one. Ready? Bob the head. As soon as you can, let's go. Sit it down and up. I'm sorry, am I getting it too fit? Should we stop now? Come on, much more to do. Easy down, easy up. Again, look at that mirror, look at that muscle. Make it work harder and harder so it becomes stronger and fitter. That's it. Good. Tell me now something. When you're working out like this, in other words, working muscle specifically towards strength, are you burning up calories? Yes, you are, obviously. Because calories means energy. Keep going. Are you burning off body fat? What do you think? Yes or no? No. Body fat, the way body fat burns. Think of it like coals on a fire. If you couldn't match the coals up on that shed, would the coals light up? No. You need wood first. So what's happening right now, yes, you're burning calories, but it's mostly glycogen. It's basically food that you recently eat within the last 12 to 24 hours. In order to burn body fat, you need a greater presence of oxygen. Which means what kind of workout you're looking at? Cardio, that's right. This is a much higher intensity. You could keep this up for long. Yeah, right now you should be thinking, please stop. Yeah, four more to go. This should be really agony now. I can feel my triceps. One more, and that's enough on this weight. Put them down for now. Really good work, girls. Really good work. Alright. Let's do a quick stretch. Arm over the top, can't be pushing here, or a little bit easier here, or even easier down the neck. And are you feeling that muscle? Post. Swap over whenever you can, girls. Good. We're about to prep for forward. We're going to move on to some leg work. You might want to keep your hand legs. I may get to use them again. I'm not sure yet. Just keep them next to your mat. Anyway, grab your mat. Put it lengthwise on the floor. Let's get to the floor work. Let's go. Lots more torture on me. Lots more exercise to do. Alright. Good. I like everyone in a sideways position. Heads facing towards the left side of the studio. Legs facing towards the right side of the studio. So in other words, lying down like so. Nice and easy. Alright, now, with most workouts that we do like squats and lots of other things, we tend to work fronts and back, but I also think it's important personally to work laterally, which means outside and inside. So we're going to affect your outer thighs and inner thighs. Which of the two do you think is the weakest one? Outer thighs, inner thighs. Usually outer thighs, unless you do something very specific. Now, I'd like you to bend your knees in the forward direction, please. Now, you can rest your head on your arm or if you prefer on your hand, do what you need to do now. Anyway, very simple. Open your legs, please, and close. And again, open your legs and close. And I've been saying that for 25 years. Seriously, let's think about what we're doing, seriously. Now, think about the muscles. We're aiming to affect outer thigh, which is based on the muscle structure, which is part of the gluteal group, which lies there, yeah? So as you lift to your leg, think about this very carefully. What should be moving? What should be moving? What should be moving? The leg. What about your hips? Should they be moving, yes or no? No, because if you look at my movement, if I'm turning my hips slightly and I'm lying down, I'm using my back muscles. So what I recommend you do while you're doing, hold to your hip bones, which are right above the leg bone, make sure they don't move. Because then you isolate the correct action from the correct muscle group instead of having other muscles help out. Stomach up as well, so think about a little bit further there. Now this is pretty easy. Yeah, this is pretty easy. You're welcome to say that. However, I'm going to make it a little more challenging. I suggest you join me. I'm going to straighten my leg now. Oh, big difference. Careful not to kick the person in front of you, unless you don't like them. That's all I meant. No, it's not. So, if that's too much, why not point it to the corner, or maybe away from you, but that's all on you. Your choice. If I'm correct, most of you can now feel it. Am I correct?
Yeah.
Why? For two reasons. One, that muscle group, those two muscles in fact, aren't that big, but also, I want you to do this. Hardly ever. See, back in my day, we did a lot of calisthenics, and we did this very regular, and we should really do this on a regular basis. But we missed it out, and we shouldn't do it. This is the kind of work you need to do in about 5 or 10 minutes. Yeah? While you watch TV. Okay? Keep going. Come on, stop giving that on me. Alright, now hold it up there. Draw me a circle. Ooh. Oh, this is good. Feel it. You can actually feel the muscle groups working. But that's what we want. Yeah? Give them a bit of a challenge. Make them firmer, make them tighter. Yeah? Get your ass in shape now. Now change direction. Don't forget breathing. Come on. I've been moaning a lot today, aren't we? Come on. For 25 years I had to listen to you moan. Come on, circle. I don't care how much it hurts. All right then. Bend your leg. Hold it on your leg. You're not done. Knee in. Push out. Come on. Into the body. Push it out. This is easy. Come on. However, I'm going to make it a bit more effective because currently, I'm not just working out spines, at this angle, I'm also working part of my quadricep. This is why it's deep. So what about if I do it this way? Knee down, foot up. So angle it, try it. Ooh. Yes, don't you love this? Keep going. I think I'll be here by myself next week. Come on, seriously. You can feel the difference. Apply the angle. Leg down, foot up. I don't care. You can stop if your leg falls off. Otherwise, carry on. Looking good. Think of it like you're pushing against something, not kicking something. Keep going, come on. Don't think of the pain, you're thinking of the pain too much. Yeah? Remember, I take no pleasure in making you suffer like this. Just four more, no pleasure at all. Give me three more, come on, seriously. Two more.
One more.
All right, knee down, give it a slap. Come on. Good work. Now, what's opposite to out of mind?
Yeah, fine.
Straight both your legs, please. Straight both legs. Now, take the top leg behind the lower leg. Now, you're welcome to sit on the floor, but personally, I find this a little more comfortable for myself to come onto my elbow. But if you are doing that, don't collapse into your collarbone, because that's going to hurt you. Try to stay upright or stay lying down. Anyway, we're going to focus on lifting up and lifting down. Start whenever you like. So now we're in the inner thigh, let's make sure we're doing it correctly. Where are our inner thighs? Obviously, inside the legs. So, if I'm working out like I'm doing right now, what do you think? Am I working the right way in the right muscle? No, because my foot is slightly turned up, I'm working my quads. And that's what squats bring you. So I need to make sure, I check for yourself, that your foot is definitely horizontal. Preferably, lead with the heel a little bit. Feel the difference it makes. By changing that rotation, you are now affecting your inner thighs. Now inner thighs are much stronger and there's much more muscle there than outer thighs. And generally it's a little bit more important. Good. So outer thighs are important because they help to shape part of your bum. What are inner thighs important for? Obviously it's nice to have the shape of the inside leg, but do they serve a function? What do? Think about walking, you didn't have inner thighs, how would you end up walking? They stabilize the center of your body. Keep going, they stabilize the center. Nobody really cares, everybody says, I'll just get on with it. Keep going. Remember, try to get your foot, if you can, above your own knee. You're fine doing this, but that's a very small range. You know, sweep it up, come on. Sweep it up in the air. Feel the work, pretend you like being here. Good, now let's change to double time. Pause. Maybe you better remember. Change your position in the upper body if you need to, you know if you're comfortable. tummy muscles. That's so useful. Always remind yourself those. Now we should start to feel a slight tingling sensation. Yeah, feel that slight tingling? Good. Carry on. Watch me. In and push. Give it a try. Still keep your foot horizontal, like you're pushing a pedal. Perfect. Feel it. Yeah. Because your hip is anchored, this has to be because it's on the floor. And you move that leg in and out, your inner body is saying, I've got to do quite a bit of work here. This is good. Keep going. Come on now. In and push. We don't have to apply an angle. We could. You could go slightly opposite if you want to. It does make it slightly harder working here. This is why we're here. Ready to draw a circle? Hold your legs straight and draw me a circle. Do not let your toes turn off, and if you can, make sure. Rest if you need to. I am certainly not making this easy, and none should you. So if you do this properly, I'll be very surprised if you can do the whole workout without stopping at least once. Come on, carry on. Yeah, carry on. Don't think of the pain too much, think of the results. Now change direction, other way. Watch that foot. If it turns up, I will chop it off. Keep your foot horizontal. Good, keep going. I'm seeing a lot of this. What is that? Are you having a bit of a problem there? Keep going. Come on, seriously. Smooth surface, like you're drawing with a pencil. Yeah? One more time, girls. Excellent. That's enough then. All right, shake the leg out. Give it a slide. All right, find your back. Let's move the tummy quickly. Let's move the tummy quickly before the other side. On your back. Hands behind you. Now, we're looking at tummy. What's the main thing we can all agree on we need to achieve in terms of shape? Flat. So whenever you do a sit-up, think of flat tummies. Hands behind your head, over the ceiling, give you what I call a normal sit-up. That means lift up maybe 6 to 7 inches, maybe a little less, maybe a little more. Notice, lift up with the upper part of your body, not the lower part. When you get to the top, however, think of the shape of your muscles in your tummy, your core. When you get to the top, are you really thinking about pulling it inwards? And remember, it doesn't come from your pelvis. Are you tilting your pelvis right now? Do you know yourself to your pelvis? How do you check? As you do lift, place one hand on your hip bone, and that hip bone should move. If you feel it rolling, what you're doing is you're giving yourself a pelvic tilt. Not ideal, because you're claiming away a lot of work away from your bum and putting it into your glutes and your hamstrings. No, it's your tummy talking. Now, how should you breathe with me? Exhale the way up, inhale the way down. It really isn't about the height. It's about you thinking, what am I telling my muscles to do now here? So when you get to the top, connect them really firmly together. Very good. If you're not sure again, have a little prop. Seriously, have a poke. What's happening below the belly button and above the groin and inside your hip bones? It's a little like diamond shape. That's the diamond shape you need to focus on. Good. Keep doing it a couple more times. Good. Just look at the time. You better go up on the other side. Take a rest. We're going to swap over. You're going to sit yourself up, please. Turn yourself around. Otherwise, you'll never do the other side. Next, the opposite way, please. Out to vice versa. So lie sideways, bend the hand or down. Knees bent to the front. Check your hip bone as soon as you can. Please lift your leg up and back down. So bend legs to start with. Watch those hips. You know exactly where you need to work. Good. And ideally, the legs should be at a right angle. So knees directly to the front. You've got a 90-degree angle. You can push them away, but again, it's not ideal. Very good. That's it, ladies. Steady up, steady down. And squeeze it, remember. There's this thing, ooh, it's fine, it's okay, no? Contract the muscle, right there. Contract it, yeah? You could squeeze your bum as well. That could help, yeah, why not? Your bum can squeeze. Too easy? It is, isn't it? Really, it is. Point your leg directly to the front if you wish. Go. So directly towards me and then try to lift. If it's too much, point a little bit more towards our core. Be careful not to kick someone, please. And check that hip. I don't want it to move. Very good. There you go. I'm not making any friends here today, am I?
No.
No? Carry on. I've got no friends. I wonder why. Carry on. Come on. We have a purpose, ladies. Keep at it. That's it. Come on. Here comes the numbing again. Keep going. That's it. Tummies, remember. Don't forget about them. Carry on, just a few more. That's it, let that pain settle in. Just get through it. Good, now hold up there, draw me a circle. Draw a circle with that leg. There we go. Check that hip again. Relax your body as much as possible. That's it, doing good. Not too fast, make it a nice big circle. Feel that, yeah? Again, it's making sure muscles working, but it's really different than this. Part of your bum shape. Ready to change direction? Arms away, babies.
Oh, yeah. That's it. Woo, gotta love it.
Come on, girls. This is booty bounce. You've got to carry on.
You're gonna love the pain. You're gonna learn to love it. That's it. This is what gives you results.
Come on, girl.
I must say, even the body under control, well done.
Excellent. Now bend the leg when you're ready.
In and push. Again, careful not to kick someone. For now, keep it horizontal. But when you're ready to do so, lean into the floor, knee down and foot up. Let's see it. And you did. And feel it. Take the rest if you really have to. I know. Don't feel sorry for yourself. Right? You've got to hammer your body into shape. Remember, your brain should be able to control your body, not the other way around. Don't make excuses.
Carry on.
Down and up, and it really doesn't take much. You walk out, you're thinking, oh my god, that really hurt, but I feel pretty good in a bizarre way. I like the way you shouted and abused me.
Carry on, keep going. Keep going, come on. Down and lift. Good, keep the angle strong, keep the abs strong, breathe strong. Keep going. Keep going. Last four. Are we feeling this now?
Yes.
Two more to go. One more.
Excellent. Give it a quick slap on the floor. Quick slap. Inner thighs, girls.
Now, straighten both legs. Take the top leg behind the lower leg. Change your upper body position if you have to. Lock your core down. Make sure the inner thigh is free to move up. Let's go now. Steady up and steady down. Don't throw the leg. Lift the leg. Watch the angle of the foot. Should your toe be pointing up?
Now, horizontal, preferably heel slightly up. Feel the difference that makes. This is perfectly fine. That's even better. Slightly higher.
Keep going. My leg don't twist that way.
Keep going. That's it. Then try to get it above your own knee. Remember, inner thighs are responsible for literally closing the legs. So you're looking at quite a wide range of motion. If you have trouble closing your legs, well, that could be a little bit of a problem.
Carry on. Seriously, make it work.
That's it. You'll find me one day, you know. Now give me double time. Just breathe. That's it. Just think of it as no effort in the world. Again, you don't allow your body to dominate your mind. Mind dominates body, isn't it? Good. Now draw me a circle. Nice and big one. Stay in control. Don't let your foot turn up. Thank you. That's it. I like the way everyone's running away. Okay, you don't need to go back to work early, but now I need to go back to work early now. I must get back to help around this.
Change direction, other way.
It's funny how you came here. You were so glad to get away from your work, and now you can't wait to go back to work.
Keep going, come on. Keep going, calm you up. Inner thighs, feel them. Literally feel them tightening up and firming up. This is the shape we want all the time, right? We're going to have to work that hard towards that.
Are you ready to pull it in and out? Hold your leg up on the floor, pull it into the chest. Right, you're pushing your pedal. Come on. In, easy, easy. In, and squeeze. That's it, ladies.
Again!
Easy, in. You're welcome to angle it, but that's your choice. This is your last one, because we're nearly out of time.
Keep going, ladies. Two more sets of legs.
Just breathe. Keep it away from the floor, keep pushing. Watch your toe angle.
And again. Easy in, easy out.
Oh, yeah. Remember, I take no pleasure in your suffering.
Last eight and you're done!
Eight.
Seven. Get it done. Come on. Thank you.
Give me four more and you're done, girls.
That's it. Good. Show me two more. I'm looking strong, by the way. Very last one. That's enough. Line your back, girls. Let's do a couple of quick stretches. I understand if you need to rush back to work, but if you can, stay. Bring your feet together and open your knees by spreading your legs, please.
Good. Give yourself that inner thigh stretch. Really well done. And of course, if you work it properly, should you feel these stretches? And you should feel something. You should feel a reaction in your muscles, yeah? They should have tightened up a little bit. Now, you're welcome to stay in this stretch, but personally, to stretch inner thighs, I prefer to do the following stretch. Close your legs back up. Bring your knees into your chest carefully. Take your legs in the air. Thank you. Put your hands in the inside of your legs, inside, very carefully, and I mean carefully, do a split stretch. Watch your upper body, keep it relaxed. Remember, if you hear a crack or a snap, thank you, you've gone too far. So don't do that. Then don't worry, the cameras are off, you'll be fine. Just relax, seriously, relax. Go back to the other stretch you did first. Seriously, if you're not comfortable, don't do it, simple as that. Good. Good. That's enough now. Come on, the legs, please. Put them on the floor. What's the other muscle working, huh? That's fine. Cross your right foot below the left knee and you're lying down. Then tuck the left knee up into your chest. Take your left hand behind your left thigh and take your right hand behind your right knee while you keep the spine flat. Good. Remember to breathe and just hold the legs. And again, should we feel a pain in the ass?
Yes.
Yeah, if you feel too much of a pain in the ass, then I'll stand further away from you, it's not a problem. Change the other leg. Thank you. So I'll see you hopefully again next year for our second session, or maybe a first session, who knows?
Bye.
Thank you. All right, that's enough. Get on the floor, come to sitting position. And that's it, that's all the time we have. Thank you so much for coming up today. Any questions, do not be shy to ask, and pat yourself on the back for doing a good workout. And yes, I think it's quite easy to play that ball, yeah. Nice and thanks, ladies. Seriously, good work, everyone. Yes, I change my classes as often as I can, although it's generally a charging strength workout, I do try to implement different ways of doing things, so you will have a bit of thanks ladies, you will always have a bit of variation, for those who are comfortable, you know that anyway. Enjoy that, yeah. We don't do enough of that forward, really. There's wheelchairs out there, even. Remember, if you can't walk, tough luck, get on with it. Thanks ladies, I know you don't need it, but thank you. Thank you, yeah, like thank you, dentist, isn't it?
Thank you.
Thank you, there, that's another sarcastic thank you. What comes up, girls? I don't know how you put up with me. Cheers, Wendy. There we go. Thank you.
Hey,
hello. Did you hear them moan as they walked out? They were moaning a lot, it was.